Now we are going to see the Speaker of Lok Sabha. The Speaker of Lok Sabha. He is the head of the Lok Sabha. And Article 93 to 97 of the Constitution deal with the office of the Speaker. Under Article 93 to 97 in our Constitution, detailedly described about the office of the Speaker. Each House of the Parliament in India has its own presiding officer. Understand? Each House of the Parliament in India, how many houses are there? Two houses. What are they? Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha. Lok Sabha presiding officer is a Speaker, and Rajya Sabha's presiding officer is ex officio chairman or vice president. So the Constitution provides a Speaker for Lok Sabha. So separately, the Constitution provided the head of the Lok Sabha is Speaker. Speaker acts as the head of Lok Sabha. He enjoys the supreme authority and power on the floor of the house. He is only the supreme authority in Lok Sabha. Who is the supreme authority in Lok Sabha? Speaker is the supreme authority in Lok Sabha. He has of great dignity and respect from all the members in the house because he is the supreme authority, so that every person in Lok Sabha gives respect to him. Every person respects him. No other office can compare with the office of Speaker in the house. No any person is equal with the Speaker. He is only the most important person in the Lok Sabha. When he speaks, no one is allowed to speak in the house. When he is starting to speak, when he is going to give his speech or anything, no one is going to speak in the house. Okay, so once again, see, in Article 93 to 97 of our Constitution deals with the office of Lok Sabha in the 93 to 97 article. Okay, each House of the Parliament in India has its own presiding officer, means in Lok Sabha, Speaker, in Rajya Sabha, the ex officio chairman, the vice president acts as the ex officio chairman. The Constitution provides a Speaker for Lok Sabha. Constitution provides a Speaker, head of the Lok Sabha Speaker. Okay, he is elected by the Lok Sabha from among the sit members. From them, the Lok Sabha members, from them they will elect one person as a Speaker. He enjoys supreme authority and powers on the floor of the house. He is the supreme power of the Lok Sabha. He has a great dignity and respect from all the members in the house. Every person gives respect to him. Every person gives a great dignity to him. Okay? And no other office can compare with the office of the Speaker in the house. He is the most powerful person in Lok Sabha. When he speaks, no one is allowed to speak in the house. When he is going to speak, no one should speak in the house. Okay, this is about the Speaker of Lok Sabha. So now, who is our Speaker? Om Birla is our Speaker. Who is our Speaker? Om Birla is our Speaker. Okay, election of Speaker. How they'll elect the members? The members of Lok Sabha elect the Speaker, amongst them one person as the Speaker. Okay, the well experienced person among them, then elect one member as a Speaker. Next, remove. If the Speaker is absent, in the place of the Speaker, Deputy Speaker will act as a Speaker. In absence of a Speaker, Deputy Speaker acts as a Speaker. Now, method of removal. Method of removal. How we will remove him? Understand? When the Speaker is not in a position to discharge his functions properly, when he is not doing his duty in a proper manner, rationally, impartially, the members of Lok Sabha can remove him. When he is not doing his duty properly, they can remove him from his post. How can they remove him? A resolution to that effect be introduced in a house with a prayer of notice 14 days before. 14 days before, they have to give a notice to whom? To Speaker. Then they have to discuss thoroughly about that in Lok Sabha. Then if it is approved by 2/3 of the strength, then he can remove from his post. Okay, how he can remove? See, when the speaker is not in a position to discharge his functions properly, impartially, and the Lok Sabha members can remove him from his post. So there is a procedure. What is that? A resolution they must produce within 14 days, prior 14 days in Lok Sabha. Then they discuss thoroughly about that. Understand? At that time when they are going to discuss about that, understand, he should not be as a speaker. Who speaker is not as a speaker? He acts as not as a speaker. Then, okay, only he can attend that, but he should not speak anything on that. Then, after that, if it is approved by 2/3 of the population strength, he can remove from his post. Salary and allowances of speaker. Salary and allowances of speaker. At present, the speaker receives a monthly salary and allowances of 1,25,000. At present, the speaker receives monthly salary and allowances of 1,25,000. Besides, along with this, he provided with the rent, house, accommodation, medical facilities, traveling facilities, and telephone facilities. Okay, along with his salary, he was provided with the rent house, rent free house, accommodation, medical facilities, and telephone facilities. Okay, it is salaries or allowances charged from the consolidated fund of India. These salaries and allowances are charged from the consolidated fund of India. Once again, see, at present the speaker receives a salary of 1,25,000. Besides, he provided with the rent free, accommodation, medical, traveling, and telephone facilities. And salary and allowances are charged from a consolidated fund of India. Next, deputy speaker. Deputy speaker. Article 93 of Indian Constitution. Article 93 of Indian Constitution provided for deputy speaker. Okay, specially provided for a deputy speaker office. The proceedings of the Lok Sabha in absence of the speaker. In absence of the speaker, the deputy speaker acts as a speaker, acts as a speaker, and the deputy speaker of Lok Sabha conducts the meetings, look after the quorum in the absence of the speaker. Okay, once again, if the speaker is absent at the time of the deputy speaker acts as a speaker. Okay, and Article 93 detailedly described about the powers and functions of deputy speaker. In the place of the speaker, the absence of the speaker, the deputy speaker conducts the meetings, look after the quorum and everything. He takes the charges of speaker, and the deputy speaker receives a monthly salary of 90,000 fixed by Parliament. It is fixed by the Parliament, and this is also charged from the Consolidated Fund of India. This is also charged from Consolidated Fund of India. Okay. Next, pro term speaker. What is it? Pro term speaker. The pro term speakers are appointed by a president. The pro term speakers appointed by president. And after every general election, normally the president appoints senior members in term of age, knowledge, and legislative rules. Who knows more number of terms elected, he elects them as a pro term speaker. As a pro term speaker, in absence of, once again, see, in absence of whom? See, pro tem speaker appointed by president. After every general election, the president conducts a meeting, and he selects the pro tem speaker. Okay, and who is elected as a pro tem speaker, the most experienced person in age and in experience persons is elected as a pro tem speakers. So what is pro tem speakers? Next one is a panel of speakers. What is the next one? Panel of speaker. The speaker nominates some of the members of a Lok Sabha as panel speakers. So at the absence of the speaker, deputy speaker acts as a speaker. At the absence of deputy speaker, pro tem speaker acts as a speaker. And at the time of absence of pro tem speaker, panel of speakers acts as a speakers. Okay, maximum strength of panel of chairpersons speakers are 10. If both the speaker and deputy speaker are absent at a particular time, one of the members from the panel of chairpersons speakers will act as a speakers. See, when the speaker and the deputy speaker, both the speakers and deputy speakers are absent at a particular time, one of the members from panel of chairperson speakers will act as a speaker, as a panel of speaker. Now we are going to see the powers and functions of speaker. Okay, what is the powers and functions of speaker? Presides the speaker, he presides over the meetings of Lok Sabha. What is that? He presides over, he conducts the meetings of Lok Sabha in a dignified manner. Okay, he determines the agenda of the meeting, what purpose they attended to the meeting, what they are going to discuss in the meeting, that he decides. Okay, he determines the agenda of the meeting. And he allows the persons, he gives time for the members to discuss about the, to give their opinions about the voting of the bills, views. He gives time for the members to discuss and to express their views on the bills. Okay, and next, he conducts the voting. If necessary, he announces the results. Okay, he conducts the voting. If necessary, he announces the results. And he sends up, he sends bills to the Rajya Sabha after they are approved by Lok Sabha. First, any bill first they introduce in the Lok Sabha. And after approving in the Lok Sabha, 2/3 of the people, if they agree, that bill he sends to Rajya Sabha for approval. He acts as a representative of Lok Sabha. He is a total person. He is the representative of Lok Sabha. Understand? So they discuss, and the result, whatever they are going to take the decision, that he takes to Rajya Sabha. So he acts as a representative of Lok Sabha. He sends messages and directs on behalf of Lok Sabha. He sends messages and directs, on behalf of Lok Sabha. So he sends the messages to Rajya Sabha, and he was the representative of Lok Sabha. Okay, he receives various petitions from the people. He receives various petitions from the people, and he discusses about on that, and he puts them in front of for voting. Then he gives his assent. Okay, next, he determines whether a bill is a money bill or not. So money bill is introduced only by the president. So whether it is a money bill or not, so he determines a bill whether it is a money bill or not. And next, he empowered to decide the quorum of the house. Understand? He empowers to decide the quorum of the house, whether all persons are attended or not, whether the attendance is there or not, to conduct the meeting. That is decided by him. He presides over the joint sessions of the parliament. What is that? He presides over the joint sessions. Joint session means Lok Sabha and Raj Sabha. In some acts, both Lok Sabha and Raj Sabha should meet at one time and they can discuss. So in that understanding, he presides over the joint sessions of the parliament. He exercises his cast vote in order to decide the future of a bill in case of members decided equally. See, if he has a veto vote, that we have to call it as a veto vote. So if a bill was tie up, if both, if he gets equal votes, then he, whether the bill must, if he votes it for a bill, it will become as a bill. If he was not voting for it, so it will not become as a bill. So he has the power to vote on the bill, okay, to decide the fate of the bill. He conducts the elections of the deputy speaker in case of vacancy. He conducts the elections for the deputy speaker in case of vacancy. He acts as a member of Commonwealth Speaker Forum, chairman of Indian Parliament. Who is he? He is the chairman of, he acts as a member and chairman of Indian Parliament, and is a head of Lok Sabha Secretariat. He is a head of Lok Sabha Secretariat. He receives the electoral certificates of new members, takes decisions and on the resignation of the members, and he presides and allots seats to the visitors and where they have to sit. See, he receives the electoral certificates of new members, takes decisions on resignation of the members, and he allots seats to the press and visitors in Lok Sabha, and he will have control and supervision over the marshal and other personnel in the premises of the house. He will have control and supervision over the marshal and other persons in the premises of the house. Okay. And he exercises his casting vote in order to decide the future of a bill in case of members are decided equally. Okay, these are the powers and functions of speaker. These are the powers and functions of speaker. Once again, you see, what are the powers and functions of the speaker? He presides over the meetings of Lok Sabha. He presides over the meetings of Lok Sabha. He determines the agenda of the meeting. He determines the agenda of the meeting to the members, and he gives a chance to discuss their views on the bills, and announces the results. Okay, and the next one is, he sends bills to the Rajya Sabha after they are approved by the Lok Sabha. He sends bills to Rajya Sabha after they are approved by the Lok Sabha. He acts as a representative of Lok Sabha. What is that? He acts as a representative of Lok Sabha. He sends messages and take decisions on behalf of the Lok Sabha. He sends messages and directs on behalf of Lok Sabha. He receives various petitions from the people and he discusses about them in Lok Sabha. He determines whether a bill is a money bill or not. He determines whether a bill is a money bill or not. And he empowered to decide the quorum of the house. Understand? He empowered to decide the quorum of the house, and he presides over the joint session of the parliament. He presides over the joint session of the parliament, and he decides the future of a bill by voting to it on. Understand? If whether a bill must be passed as a bill or not, if he votes, it becomes as a, so that is only known as veto vote, that the power he has. He decides, understand, when it is equally voted, then he decides to win the bill. Okay, so he votes on it. These are the powers and functions of these are the powers and functions of the speaker. He conducts the elections of the deputy speaker in case of vacancy. He conducts the elections of deputy speaker in case of vacancy. He acts as a member of Commonwealth Speakers Forum. He is called as a chairman of Indian Parliament or head of Lok Sabha Secretariat. He is the head of Lok Sabha Secretariat. He receives the electoral certificates of new members, takes decisions and he signs on resignations of the members, and he gives a separate seat for present visitors. Understand? And he has control, and he is a superior and a marshal and other persons in the matter of Lok Sabha. These are the powers and functions of the speaker. Okay, understand? These are the powers and functions of the speaker. Parliament has two houses. That previously we studied that Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. In previous session, we discussed thoroughly about Lok Sabha. Now we are going to see about Rajya Sabha. Okay, see, Rajya Sabha in Article 80 of the Indian Constitution deals with the composition, election, procedure and function of Rajya Sabha. What is it? Article 80 of Indian Constitution deals with the composition, election procedure and functions of Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha is also known as upper house or second chamber in the Union Legislature. Rajya Sabha is also known as upper house or second chamber in the Union Legislature. It is also called as the Council of States, because here the members are elected indirectly, so that it is also called as the Council of States. And the Rajya Sabha membership depends upon the population of the state. Okay, the Rajya Sabha membership depends upon the population of the state. The Rajya Sabha was constituted on April 3rd, 1952, and its first sitting was held on May 13, 1952. See, the first Rajya Sabha was constituted on April 3rd, 1952, and its first sitting was held on May 13, 1952. Okay, now we are going to see about the composition. Okay, see, the Rajya Sabha consists of members representing the states and union territories. Okay, the Rajya Sabha consists of members representing of states and union territories, whereas the Lok Sabha members are elected directly. Okay, so its total strength is 250. Out of them, its total members are 250. Its total members are 250, and out of them, 12 members are nominated by the president. 12 members are nominated by the president on the advice of the Council of Ministers and Prime Minister. Okay, who is, what is it? See, the total strength of Rajya Sabha is 250. Out of them, 12 members are nominated by President on the advice of Union Council of Ministers and PM, Prime Minister. Okay, there will be Chairman and Deputy Chairman of Rajya Sabha. See how there is a Speaker, Deputy Speaker, panel of speakers like that. Here, the head of the Rajya Sabha is Chairman. Okay, the head of the Rajya Sabha is Chairman and Deputy Chairman. Okay, in the absence of the Chairman, the Deputy Chairman acts as the Chairman. Okay, so Chairman is the presiding officer. He conducts the meetings of Rajya Sabha. Who conducts the meetings of Rajya Sabha? The Chairman conducts the meetings of Rajya Sabha. The Deputy Chairman presiding over the meetings of the House in the absence of the chairman. So here the deputy chairman, in a where if the speaker is absent, the deputy speaker handles the charge. Like that here, the if the chairman is absent, in the absence of the chairman, the deputy chairman take over the meeting in the place of chairman. Okay, once again, see the composition of Rajya Sabha. It consists of members representing of the states and union territories. Its total strength is 250. Out of them, 12 are nominated by the president on the advice of Union Council of Minister and Prime Minister. There will be a chairman and a deputy chairman in the Rajya Sabha. Okay, chairman is the presiding officer. He conducts the meeting. In the absence of the chairman, okay, the deputy chairman acts as the chairman. He conducts the proceedings. Okay, so the vice president acts as the ex officio chairman of Rajya Sabha. So at present, Venkaiah Naidu is the ex officio chairman of Rajya Sabha. Election of Rajya Sabha. The members of the Rajya Sabha are elected by the state legislative assembly. These members are not elected directly by the constitution members. So constituency members. So that, understand, it is indirect elections. So the members of Rajya Sabha are elected by the state legislative assemblies. The election takes place by means of proportional representation according to the members of the state. These persons are elected. The Election Commission of India organizes these elections. So, we will conduct the elections of this. The Election Commission of India organizes these elections. Okay, qualifications. What are the qualifications of the Rajya Sabha members? See, first, he shall be a citizen of India. What is the first one? He shall be a citizen of India. He shall have completed 30 years of age. He shall have completed completed 30 years of age. And he shall not hold any office of profit under the union or state government. He should not be in any government position in state government or the central government. He shall be resident of the state for a maximum of 6 months. Because it is a state representation, so that the person who is going to contest in the elections must be resident of the same state at least 6 months. Okay, he should not be insane or bankrupt. Okay, so he must be a very good person, and he shall possess such other qualifications as prescribed by the parliament. Understand? And the rules and regulations which lie in the constitution, he must follow those. Okay, these are the qualifications. Once again, see, he shall be citizen of India. He shall have completed 30 years of age. He shall not hold any office of profit under the union or state government, and he shall be a resident of the state for a maximum of 6 months, and he should not be insane or bankrupt, and he shall possess such other qualifications as prescribed by the parliament. Okay, next, term of office. So it is a permanent house, like Lok Sabha, it never dissolves, so that it is a permanent house. Okay, it is a permanent house. Tenure of the members is 6 years. Their Lok Sabha members tenure is 5 years. Here the Rajya Sabha members tenure is 6 years. Okay, it is not subjected to dissolution. So I told you, no, it never dissolves. Okay, Rajya Sabha never dissolves. Election to Rajya Sabha is called biannual elections. What it is called? The elections which are conducted to Rajya Sabha is called as biannual elections. What is the meaning of biannual elections? It means 1/3 of its members shall retire at the end of every 2 years. Understand? All persons at a time, they won't retire. So that 1/3 of its members shall retire at the end of every 2 years. Okay, once again, you see elections. The members of the Rajya Sabha are elected by the state legislative assemblies. Okay, it is not direct elections, it is indirect elections. So the elections takes place by the means of proportional representation. It depends upon the population of the state. Okay, the Election Commission of India organizes these elections. These elections are indirect elections, so these elections are organized by the Election Commission of India. Okay, qualifications of a Raj Sabha members. He shall be a citizen of India. Next, he shall have completed 30 years of age. Okay, he shall not hold any office of profit under union or state government, and he shall be a resident of the state for a maximum of 6 months. He must be a resident of that particular state for maximum 6 months, and he should not be insane or bankrupt, and he shall possess such other qualifications as prescribed by the parliament. Okay, term of office, it is a permanent house, it is not dissolved like Lok Sabha. Tenure of the members is 6 years. Then the Lok Sabha members tenure is 5 years, here Raj Sabha members tenure is 6 years. It is not too subjected to dissolution. There the Lok Sabha dissolves, but here the Raj Sabha never dissolves. Election to Raj Sabha is called as biannual elections because it never dissolves, so it is known as a biannual elections. It means 1/3 of its members shall retire at the end of every 2 years. All members never retires at a time, so that it is a permanent house. The 1/3 of its members shall retire at the end of every 2 years.